Hi there, my name's Lee Bushin and I'm a solution architect for NVIDIA, and today I'd like to talk to you about some of the GPUs that we've released in 2021 in the new Ampere range of GPUs. Today I'm going to be concentrating specifically on this GPU here, which is the A16 GPU. So what area of the market is this GPU aimed at? Well, you know, we've got a number of GPUs that we're releasing in 2021, and this one is aimed fairly and squarely at the knowledge worker stroke office worker type of workload. Now, for some time, we've had another GPU in the market that has been aimed at the knowledge worker workload, and that is this guy here, the NVIDIA M10. This is still a great GPU, has 32 gigabytes of memory on it, so it's very good for high density VDI deployments. We also had another GPU in between the M10 and the A16 that we have been recommending for the last couple of years for knowledge worker workloads. And that's this guy here, the NVIDIA T4. This is still a great GPU. We continue to produce this GPU and will do for some time to come. It's got a really good niche in terms of what it's aimed at. It's really good for knowledge worker workloads. As I've said, it's also very good for edge deployments. So edge deployments where you're doing things like artificial intelligence, inference, that kind of thing. And it's also good for maybe low-end professional visualization workloads as well. Things such as maybe, you know, if you're using AutoCAD or some low-end applications like that that don't need too much graphical grunt. So what are some of the things about the NVIDIA A16 that makes it so relevant for office worker workloads? Well, the first one is that this isn't a single GPU, actually. This is actually four GPUs all connected together using a Mellanox PCIe switch. And what that's really good for is, firstly, contention. So I'll explain what I mean by that. So the way that virtual GPU slices up that GPU between multiple users is based on time. So take this GPU, for instance. This has got a single GPU chip on it. And if you have 16 users on this GPU, they each get a slice of this GPU. They don't get a slice of a few of the cores, maybe each. What they have is access to the whole GPU for their own time slice. So effectively, the more users you put on this, the longer the queue there is for processing on the GPU. 16 is fine on this GPU. It's been tested and, you know, it works really well. But anything more than 16, say when you start getting up to 24 users on a GPU, this can actually become a problem. So the great thing about having four GPUs is effectively you end up with four queues down to that GPU, which means now you have four queues, there's much less contention on this card, which allows you to put more and more users onto here without there being, you know, conflicts between all of the users on here. Another good thing about having four GPUs is the fact that you can run different profiles on each GPU. So one of the things that you might know about our single GPU cards is that once you put a profile on it, say you put a 2 gigabyte profile, you can only host 2 gigabyte profiles on that card until you clear that card down of virtual machines and maybe load a 4 gigabyte profile VM onto it, in which case it can then handle 4 gigabyte profiles. The great thing with this is because we've got four GPUs, we've actually got four sets of memory as well. So, you know, GPU 1, for instance, you could be running 1 gigabyte knowledge worker profiles. GPU 2, you could be running 2 gigabyte or 4 gigabyte GPU profiles for higher powered users. You could even be running different licenses. So you could be running a virtual workstation license on here, and maybe on another GPU on this card, you could be running standard office workers. So the choice is really yours, and it gives you a lot more flexibility in day-to-day management of the GPU and your users. Now, the next thing that makes this GPU really, really important for high-density office workers is the fact that this has 64 gigabytes of memory on this. So in theory, it can host 64 users per GPU card. If you compare that to the M10 before it, that has 32 gig of RAM. So it's got twice as much RAM as the previous generation that we had. The T4 has 16 gig of RAM. So in theory, two T4s equal one M10 in terms of the number of density you can get. This A16, though, you can get double the density on this GPU. So if you put a couple of GPUs, a couple of A16s into your server, you're talking 128 users on that server, all with 1 gigabyte profiles in that case. Now, you could potentially go up to 3 GPUs, 3 A16s in a host, but then you start going up against the limit of CPU contention on that server. So probably a sweet spot for us that we see is going to be 2 A16s in a host. So it's worth mentioning that it's not always about 1 gigabyte profiles and 64 users on this card. As workloads become more and more heavy and people are needing more and more screen real estate, so more monitors, higher resolution monitors, the need for maybe a 2 gigabyte frame buffer or even maybe a 4 gigabyte frame buffer per virtual machine has actually gone up over the last few years. So bear in mind as well that you'll be able to put 32 users with a 2 gigabyte profile on this card, or 16 users with a 4 gigabyte profile. So the choice is yours. Now, there are two things that are really important for an office worker class GPU to have. One of them is lots of memory, and the other one is lots of encoders and decoders. And the A16 has 4 encoders on it. Now, why are encoders important? Well, the frames that come from the data center from those virtual desktops need to be encoded in some fashion and then sent down to the endpoint for decoding by the user's endpoint machine. If you do that in CPU, that actually creates a load on the CPU. So if you can offload that onto the GPU, it's going to actually make latency a lot quicker and make the user's desktop experience much better. So the 4 encoders that we have on the A16 here are the latest generation. They're about 3 times as performant as the encoders that we had on the M10 back here. So they offer great performance for our end users. So decoders are also really important to have on a GPU, especially for knowledge workers where they're doing lots of video-based content, lots of video conferencing, lots of CEO broadcasts, training videos, that sort of thing. And the A16 has a massive 8 decoders to decode traffic. We decode all the standard stuff like H.264 and H.265. We also support VP9. And the A16 actually supports AV1 as well, decode, which is really important. If you look at most YouTube videos today that you play, if you right click on the video and say stats for nerds, you'll actually see it was encoded using AV1. So the ability to have that decoded on the GPU itself is going to give much better performance for the end user. Also, having lots of encoders and decoders on this GPU means it opens up a whole new load of use cases for transcoding for other applications other than knowledge worker workloads too. Now, another thing to point out about this Ampere generation GPU is that it has the same tensor cores and the same ray tracing cores as the A40, which you can see over my shoulder behind now, just fewer of them. So it can actually open the door for maybe having some mixed workloads. So during the day, you could do VDI. During the night, you could potentially do some sort of AI workload or maybe some rendering workloads as well. So in terms of performance, the GPU hasn't been released yet, so it's kind of fairly early days. But we've done some rough benchmarking tests in between the M10 here and the A16 using the VP 2020 benchmark, and we've actually found that the A16 is twice the performance of the M10, something we probably expect in between those two generations. However, just to point out that in terms of GPU pure raw power, the A16 isn't really designed as having a massive amount of raw power. It's not something that a lot of knowledge worker workloads will need. What it is designed to have, though, is the main attributes that knowledge worker workloads do need, and that is a lot of memory and a lot of encoders and decoders. So you couldn't really compare the A16 performance, for instance, to something like an A10 or an A40. So the next question is, when can you get your hands on this A16 GPU in your server? And that's a question that I'm being asked a lot by our customers. We actually announced this earlier on in the year. And the answer is, to cut a long story short, probably towards the end of the year, 2021, that is. When we release a GPU, the first thing that needs to happen, obviously, is the GPU gets released into the market. We then have to support it with virtual GPU. That's something that's coming in the next release, so that'll be there fairly short order. The next thing, of course, is that our hardware manufacturers need to certify these GPUs in their chassis. As you can tell from all of these GPUs that I've got in front of me here, they're passively cooled. So the cooling for these GPUs is actually done from the server chassis itself. So those server chassis need to be certified to provide enough power and enough cooling for these GPUs, which is why it takes a little while for servers to be certified after a GPU is shipped. So one thing to point out is that in between the Turing and Ampere generation, we actually change the way that virtual GPU addresses and splits up that GPU. We use a proprietary method in the Turing generation, but for Ampere, we've actually moved to using SRIOV technology to talk to the GPU. What this means is that for the hypervisors that support virtual GPU, they need to also support NVIDIA GPUs with SRIOV. In terms of VMware, that actually started support as of version 7 update 2. So for vSphere 7 update 2 is what you're going to need if you're going to deploy an Ampere generation GPU for virtual GPU. So another thing to point out is that the A16 is going to be supported as part of our EGX platform. So this will be NVIDIA certified for EGX solutions too. So just to summarise, the A16, a great GPU for knowledge worker workloads. It has all the attributes needed for those knowledge workers, multiple GPUs for low contention, and lots of memory, 64 gigabytes of RAM. Also, it has lots of encoders and decoders of the latest generation to get the best performance possible for your users. Check out the NVIDIA website for further information, and hopefully see you back here soon, where I'm going to be talking about the big brothers of the A16, which are the A10 and the A40.